We begin, good morning class, we begin with continuous tenses. Now this is a new heading and I don't want anyone to get disturbed and understand the concept very clearly. Now continuous, the word continuous tells us that the action was in progress, whether it was in the past, the action was in progress in the past, then it is called past continuous. When the action was in the present, it is considered as the action being done in the present. It is present continuous. And when the action was in the future, that means it might happen, it will happen, and the action continues in progress, that is called the future continuous. Now, there are three varieties, and we'll see. Like, supposing when we are saying in the
present. Can you please tell the page number?
It is on page 73, 72, 73. So, when we talk of present continuous, it means I am talking, right? I'm continuing that action. The verb is continued, is in progress. So that is the present continuous. I'm talking to you. I'm eating my food. I'm drawing on the wall. Now this action is continued. Main ye kar raha hun. I am eating. I am dancing. All this is in action in progress. So that is called present continuous. Now when we talk of the past, we say something like this. I was eating, I was dancing, I was drawing on the wall. Main ye sab kar raha tha. That means the action progressed and it ended right now, just before the present tense came. Okay. Now when we talk of future continuous, we say I will be eating, I will be dancing, I will be watching television, I will be drawing on the wall. Main ye sab karunga. Okay, it is still not done, but in future, whenever it will be done, it will be in progress, it will be in succession. So I will just show you a little portion on the blackboard which could help you. Can you all turn my camera? Only I can turn my camera, children.
Yes, ma'am. Only you can turn your
camera. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yeah. It has turned, I think. Is it? Has it?
Ma'am, now.
No, ma'am, your video is paused.
Okay. Wait a second.
Anyways, can you see anything? Can you see me or can you see the blank?
Paused video.
No, ma'am.
I paused the video. Now, how will I open it?
Ma'am, now you are again open.
No, it's moving.
Okay. So, which side can you see? Can you see the blackboard side or can you see me?
Ma'am, only you.
Ma'am, we are able to see you.
You are only able to see me. What if I turn the camera? Can you see now the blackboard?
Ma'am, your video is paused.
Yes, ma'am, it's paused.
Okay.
Yes. Ma'am, you can present your screen and open the camera.
Okay, but I'll have to screen share, no, if I do that. Anyway, let us see. So here there are simple tenses where we talk of simple tense, where the simple tense is in present, we say I eat. In the past tense, I ate. In the future tense, I will eat. Now this is simple tense. When we talk of continuous tense, we are using the ing verbs. Now in the present continuous, it will be I am eating. In the present simple, see, it is I eat. I am eating. Now in continuous past tense, we say I was eating. Whereas in simple past, we said I ate. Okay, I was eating. Now for future continuous tense, we say I will be eating. And whereas in simple future, we say I will eat. Okay, so here is a picture. Can you all see a little thing on the blackboard? Can you all?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
I cannot. Ma'am, your camera is off. Ma'am, now
yes,
it's paused.
Now it is paused.
Yes,
yeah,
ma'am.
Karu.
Yes, ma'am.
Do one thing, all of you
I'm
switch off your cameras.
Camera
switch off your cameras so that at least there is little power in the Skype class to show us things. Because of high resolutions of your screens, maybe it is not visible. Just try switching off your own cameras. Please,
ma'am switched
please.
Off.
Ma'am
okay.
switched off.
Okay, so give us some time. Okay, let me quickly read out the answers to you. Now, A exercise, Jack has come to page 74. Fill in the blanks with simple present or present continuous. Number one, Jack has a sore throat. He says he is feeling feverish too. Number two.
I think we have done this.
I know, yes, I'm doing everything so that you get one recorded video. Number two, the rain comes in through the crack of the in the window pane. Number three, Anushka troubles me a lot. She begins to sing when I am doing my homework. Number four, the Ganga flows through many parts of India. It floods quite often, but is making the soil fertile. Now coming on to number five, Tanya likes to sketch and draw. Right now she is painting a portrait. Number six, Deepika loves to read biographies. At the moment, she is reading a biography of M.S. Ramachandran. Number seven, I can see the cows grazing in the green grass of the pastures. Puneet said, I'm going on a trek to the hills. Now, fill in B exercise, fill in the blanks with simple present or the present continuous forms of the verbs given in brackets. Number one, Mala wants to improve her English. She is making an effort to meet more people and practice her speaking skills. Her teacher is giving her extra classes. The classes begin after lunch and continues till tea time. Mala hopes that her marks will improve. She is aiming for a score of 60%. Number two, today is the third day of my trek around the Valley of Flowers. I'm tired, my legs are shaking, my feet hurt, and my toes bleed. But I want to continue. I'm trying to adapt to the high altitude. I'm learning a little bit about the flowers found here. Unfortunately, I did not learn about flora quickly. I believe I'm improving gradually. I'm currently traveling with Akash, a student from St. Xavier's Boys School in Mumbai. He is sweet but impatient. He always walks behind me and complains that I'm too fast. Now we come on to past continuous tense. That means action done in the past. It is still continuing in progress. So we come across the C exercise.
Ma'am, now your video is working.
Yes,
okay.
Ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you. C exercise, fill in the blanks with simple past tense or past continuous tense. My brother was waiting for me at the airport when my plane landed. Number two, Faisal hurt his finger while he was hammering a nail into the box. Number three, the power went off while I was watching the film. Number four, it began to rain when we were playing the finals. Number five, I came across many interesting pictures when I was surfing the internet. Number six, the boys were stealing mangoes, then the watchman saw them. Number seven, it began to rain when we were waiting at the bus stop. Number eight, the students were playing in the classroom when the teacher entered. Okay, now we come on to future continuous. That means the action which was done in future and it would continue. Yeah, like I will be going for a holiday. Now I will be going. I will be eating my breakfast. Now all these things will happen in the past. Okay, so How do you frame it? You put the subject, I, then you say will be or shall be, then you put verb plus ing, that means verb will be eat and ing, so I will be eating my breakfast, rest of the sentence, okay? So you can see here, then if it is a negative sentence, how do you do it? I will be the subject, will be the future continuous form, then not, I will not be, it's a negative sentence, so you'll say not be eating, verb plus ing, that means eat is a verb and ing, so eating my breakfast. So this turns out to be a negative sentence. I will not be eating my breakfast. Okay. Then interrogative. Will you be eating your breakfast? Interrogative means question in a question form. So will or shall will be placed in the beginning. Then the subject, you, verb, be, auxiliary verb, be, present participle, that means the verb plus ing will be, eat will be the verb, ing is the word, eating your breakfast. And it turns out to be a question. Okay, now coming on to D exercise, change the verbs in these sentences into the future continuous tense. The heat is suffocating. Answer, the heat will be suffocating. Number two, they were singing a song. Answer, they will be singing a song. Number three, we are enjoying the party. Answer, we will be enjoying the party. Number four, they are watching TV. Answer, they will be watching TV. Number five, she is washing the car. Answer, she will be washing the car. Number six, the plaster of the old house is crumbling. Answer, the plaster of the old house will be crumbling. Number seven, he is pestering me with questions. Answer, he will be pestering me with questions. Number eight, she is painting the setting sun. Answer, she will be painting the setting sun. Number nine, she is looking after her sister's dog. Answer, she will be looking after her sister's dog. Number 10, they are getting married on Sunday. Answer, they will be getting married on Sunday. E exercise, identify the tenses of the highlighted verb. I was resting. Now, was resting is what? Was is the past ing added to the verb. It is telling you past continuous. Okay? So the answer is past continuous. Next, Maya is talking with her friends. Is present, talking, ing. So present continuous. Pia was riding. Was riding will be past continuous. I will be using is future continuous. We are visiting grandpa, are visiting, present continuous. I will be relaxing, will be is telling you future, ing is telling you future continuous. The children are swimming, present continuous. She will be exercising all evening, future continuous. The dog was barking, past continuous. Is this much clear to each one of you?
Yes,
ma'am. Is this much clear to you?
Ma'am.
Okay. So now,
yes,
in this exercise, exercise D, you will do the fourth one, the seventh one. In E exercise, you will do the first one. You will do the third, just a second, the fourth one and the fifth one. Okay. D and E clear. Now come on to C exercise. You will do the fifth one and the eighth one. Come turn over. Come to B exercise. Leave this. Come to A exercise. You will do the third one and the fifth one. Am I clear? I repeat. A exercise 3 and 5. B, you will not do in the copy. C exercise 5 and 8. D exercise 4 and 7. E exercise 1, 4 and 5. I hope I'm clear.
Ma'am, we don't have to write the definition of past continuous tense.
No, children, no need. And even if I'm sending you the old explanations, please do not get confused with what I told those children. Follow just what I told you. Just listen. Pardon, child, I could not get you. Acha, just a second, listen to me once again regarding the simple tenses exercise given on page 68, 67 and all. Now, in this exercise, B will be done completely. Whereas when I'm sending you the videos, in that they have said only a few ones, but in actually, you are supposed to do all the B exercise 15 questions in your copies. Why? Because it is going to help you practice. Plus, it will, if you do it in the book, it will be smudged up. Okay? So it is better you do it in your copies. Is this much clear to you? Exercise B, I told you to do in the copies. On page 69, exercise B, do it in your copies. I'm getting this recorded for you, so that once you see this video, you are very clear that what your teacher wants out of these grammar exercises from simple tenses and from continuous tenses. Okay? Continuous tenses, I've just now told you. Simple tenses, I again came back to the previous chapter and I'm telling you exercise B is to be done. Okay?
And ma'am, D, 6, 10 and
12. And ma'am, D,
6, 10. I'm coming. Exercise B, you will do all 15. Exercise D, you will do the 6th one, the 10th one and the 12th one. Okay, everything clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
If you have any doubts, please text me or send me an audio in the group only, so that it helps me whenever I get time, I respond to you. Okay, and since I have a little pain on my back because of the accident, I quite often find myself resting once I am not teaching you all. So while I'm resting, because doctor has said not to move a lot, my backbone is a little injured. Oh, I'm getting this recorded. Please stop this.